Let's talk about VP Lenny. She admitted that she doubts her own viability, her own winnability for 2022, and she is weighing, in effect, would her 6% be, would that grow and make her win, or would that, for example, benefit another candidate? And she said, we can't take 6 years of the same. Those were her statements, not mine. So I'm curious, do you believe she should still run? Or at this point, do you believe that it's time already to really rally behind a stronger opposition candidate or an alternative? I think that's the best word, an alternative candidate against, let's say, the leading candidate today being Sara Duterte.
Oh, well, with all due respect, no, wala sa listahan po ng mga posible si Mayor. Pero speaking of VP Lenny, she's really one of the at least three presidential since 2 years ago nga na kausap ko. I think it's very responsible of her bilang pinakamataas na opposition leader namin hanggang ngayon to weigh things, to mull the possibility of an alternative. But until today, Karen, I think she is still, no, not just statistically, pero symbolically, one of the key figures na
yes, no doubt,
sa tingin ng mga tao dapat i-consider. At kinokonsider.
So dapat malakasan na lang niya ang loob niya at tumakbo. Palagi mo, Senator Risa, just offhand. I mean, do you believe that sometimes it's a leap of faith? Gawin na lang niya? Anong nakikita niyo?
For sure, it's a leap of faith at ang lalim ng balon ng faith ni VP Lenny.
Okay.
At naniniwala ko, naranasan ko yung lakas ng loob niya. I just have to respect also that she feels the need to consider alternatives. But until the last moment, I know that isa siya sa pinakamalakas na possible contenders at pinakamalakas din na if not queen maker or king maker, para pag-isahin at palakasin ang isang non-administration candidate para sa pagka-presidente. I have full faith in
her. Yeah. So VP Lenny has admitted as far as, I'm not sure if it was meeting with Isko or dialoguing with him. Is that a possibility for you, supporting Mayor Isko as president? Who would you support for as president if VP Lenny doesn't run?
I would support, if VP Lenny doesn't run, I would support a candidate or a united front of candidates na committed to end this kind of terrible malgovernance na nararanasan natin the past half decade into this terrible pandemic.
But do you have a name? I mean, do you have a name? Because there are just a few that can run, let's face it. You have Bongbong Marcos in the survey, Manny Pacquiao, Isko Moreno in the survey, and now you already have Lacson, who's already declared, so to speak, announced. So roughly you have four. So if she doesn't run, who personally would you choose? Who would you support?
I don't have a name yet as of this day, Karen. I have a similar, maybe short list than you mentioned. Pero hindi naman ito magiging unang kampanya na halos down to the wire yung pagbubuo ng hindi lang isang slate, but hopefully a broader united front slate. And I'm still really working on that among others working on it.
All right. Yeah. Now, some netizens have said masyadong garapal yung pagtakbo ng Duterte, right? But let's balance it. You have Harry Roque saying that the Duterte won't happen, Ago Duterte won't happen, meaning at least in one party. But you also have others saying, what makes this different from, let's say, two Aquinos, two Macapagals? Bakit yun hindi tinawag na garapal? Go ahead, Senator.
We never had a President Aquino and Vice President Aquino. We never had a President Macapagal and a Vice President Macapagal.
At the same
and
time.
And in fairness to them, at the same time. So unprecedented itong pag-iisip ni Presidente aloud na tatakbo silang Vice President at posible sa isang slate na yung top two names ay magkapamilya. Unprecedented at simply unacceptable, Karen.
Okay, that's a good point. I've interviewed many people on this, and they've never pointed that out, that it's unprecedented, that it's at the same yes. time, because it's always right. brought up that Cory won, Noynoy ran, mm-hmm. President Makapagal won, Gloria ran, but then you're talking about many Absolutely. Years apart.
Apart, exactly. Hindi magkasabay.
Okay, mm-hmm. moving forward, the Supreme Court just recently made a decision and said, frankly, that the president can evade the ICC and the treaty on his own. Yes. What do you make of the Supreme Court's decision first? Were you surprised that they voted unanimously?
I'm very pleasantly surprised, or not surprised, I really welcome this ruling of the Supreme Court. Bagamat dinismiss nila yung mga petition tungkol dito, their ruling now clearly states for us, which is a very thick silver lining on our dark horizon, they clearly stated na hindi unlimited ang kapangyarihan ng presidente to withdraw from international treaties. And you know, as someone working in the Senate, I hear this with very glad ears na dahil kami bilang treaty-making body, we are particularly invested in this issue. At sinabi din ng Korte Suprema that the president, as you said, Karen, may not evade, is obliged to cooperate with the ICC kung ipagpatuloy nila yung kanilang proseso, particularly yung investigation. Mm-mm. So I have right. bad news for human rights violators, Karen. They are not off the hook. Darating ang araw, mananagot sila sa mga heinous na gawain nila sa mamamayang Pilipino.
Mm-mm. All right. There's a question here that came in. Can you ask Senator Ontiveros her thoughts about Willie Revillame running and or possibly running, and Rafi Tulfo possibly throwing his hat in the ring?
Well, Mr. Revillame and Tulfo, like every citizen, have the right not only to vote, but to present themselves as candidates to be voted on by the electorate. So that's the same principle for every Filipino. Mm-mm. So it will be up to the voters to decide.
Okay. You know, joining debates in the Philippines is not mandatory, right? That's the interesting right. part. Unlike the United States, where for you to be yes. the representative of the party, you'd have to go through the debates within mm-hmm. the party first. And do you believe that joining a debate should be made into a requirement? And I don't know if the COMELEC level alone can include that.
Sorry, medyo naghang ako, but I caught the beginning and the end of your main question. Well, hindi ko alam sa ibang mga partido, pero sa Akbayan Party, nagde-debate kami. But if you're talking about the highest debates and then the senatorial debates, yes, I wish it were mandatory for all of us. Pero kung hindi pa rin gagawin yun, lalo na ngayon sa panahong ito, and then hirap pa dahil sa pandemya, then we, the politicians, the candidates next year, must bring the content of that debate to the people. At baka nga hindi na namin kailangang dalhin yung buong yun, Karen, kasi yung debate, pumapasok na sa mismong puso ng mga tao, pumapasok sa mga tahanan natin. The debates are about the pandemic, the recession, the debates are out in our ocean about China, the debates are in our households about the corruption na nagnanakaw ng pera dapat para sa mga serbisyong panlipunan, lalo na ngayong pandemya at recession. But definitely, those are issues, debated or not, informal debates, na dadalhin namin, pag-uusapan at dapat papakinggan namin sa mga kababayan natin, sa mga botante.
All right. On that note, Senator Risa Ontiveros, I want to thank you so much for joining me this morning. God bless you, and you take care.
I can bless you.
Are you going around right now? You look like you're in the province.
I'm on the road.
I was going to say.
Out of town.
All right. Be careful with the Delta variant or the COVID variant.
Right.
Be
Stay
careful.
Healthy also, Karen.
All right. Thank you so much. That's Senator Risa Ontiveros.